RevenueCat stands out as the best platform for iOS subscriptions, largely to its powerful paywall feature. This feature allows developers to easily create, customize, and optimize paywalls without needing complex backend infrastructure. RevenueCat also provides detailed insights into user behavior, helping to refine paywalls for higher engagement and retention. The seamless integration of these paywall tools streamlines the subscription process, making it a top choice for iOS app developers. So, let me show you how you can add it to a SwiftUI. RevenueCat is amazing, and one of my favorite features are the paywalls. Today, I'm going to show you how to integrate paywalls into your SwiftUI application. So, just a little bit of preparation right over here. I created an app delegate adapter, and the content view has a scroll view with some text over here, and basically that's it. Here's the app delegate content view, and the app delegate is accessed on the app file. Basically, that's it. And the other one is that I have set up my subscriptions on App Store Connect. I have created a pro group, and inside the pro group, I have free subscriptions weekly, monthly, and yearly. And if it's going to load, we are going to take a look at it. And here they are. Weekly, monthly, and yearly. Okay, and of course, I have set everything up. It's ready to submit. Make sure that you also set up all of your contracts. So in-app purchases should work. So what is the first step that we need to do? Well, we want to add the RevenueCat iOS SDK. So it's right over here, github.com/RevenueCat/purchases-iOS. And what I'm going to do is add it through Swift Package Manager. So copy that link out, and let's go back to Xcode, and then select our project, package dependencies, and click on plus over here, and the URL over there. And we should be able to add the package. That's right. And we want to make sure that you select RevenueCat and also RevenueCat UI, because we are going to use the paywalls from the RevenueCat UI. So let's add that package. Currently, it's version 5.3.3, just so you know what this tutorial is based on. Okay, so next up, we want to create a store kit configuration file. So let me just create a new file from template, and then let's just have a store kit configuration file. Let's click on next over there. And what you want to do is you want to sync this file with an app on App Store Connect, which means that it's just going to sync whatever we already set up in App Store Connect. Or if you choose the other way around, you can set up things in this file, and then it will be synced to App Store Connect. Anyway, I like that this syncing is available to us. So the name RevenueCat paywall, that's fine. Let's click on next, and make sure that the target is selected, and let's create that. Okay. So let's just wait for that. It should be synced shortly. There we go. We have the monthly, weekly, yearly over there. Okay, that's fine. So now what we want to do is make sure that our project actually uses this one. So head over to edit scheme over here, and then select run and options, and then select under store kit configuration what you have created, RevenueCat paywalls.storekit. That's the one. Okay, now you may close it. Okay, so that's how you want to set up a local version of your in-app purchases. Okay, now we want to create a new RevenueCat project right now. Let's go to our browser and log into RevenueCat if you haven't already done so. And then what you want to do is create a new project. So let's click on create new project. Project name, let's just call this Paywalls 2024 with two L's over there. Let's create the project. Okay, so next what you want to do is add an App Store app to it. For that, I'm just going to switch back to Xcode and grab my bundle identifier. Let me just do that real quick. Here we go. Just copy it out. We're going to use it. So there we go. App name, paywalls. Well, that's fine for the app name. That's great. And then what you want to do is paste in your app bundle ID. That's com.rebeloper.revenuecatpaywalls in my case. Next, what you want to do is add the App Store Connect app-specific shared secret, not the general shared secret, the app-specific shared secret. Now, there is some info how you can add it, get it. Go ahead and read it. Basically, what you want to do is go into your app and then select distribution, and then just select app information, and right over there, scroll all the way down, and you will see this, what we see right over here, app-specific shared secret. Click on manage. You may regenerate this. I'm just going to copy this out, clicking on done, and then let's just go back. Where are we? Oh, here it is. And then set the secret. Paste it in and then click on set. Okay. Next, what you want to do is add an in-app purchase key configuration. Now, this is important because RevenueCat wants to communicate with App Store Connect. Therefore, you need to create this one. It can be created under users and access, so it's not specifically for your application. Users and access, integrations, and then select in-app purchase. Now, as you can see, I have already created some, but let's just generate a new one. Click on generate, a name. I'm just going to call it subscription key again. Let's generate it. Okay, download the key. Download it. Make sure that you save it somewhere safe. You cannot download it again, as you can already tell. Now, what you want to do is go back and drag and drop it. So let's go to my downloads. There it is. Let's drag and drop it right over there. Okay. Key ID, issuer ID. Now, the issuer ID will be populated after you actually created a key. It's right over here. Let's copy it out and then paste it in. And let's save the changes right now, because after we save the changes, we will have some other options too, like App Store Connect API. So why do we want to do this? Well, that's because we might as well add our products manually over here, but we can also fetch them from App Store Connect, like we did with Xcode. So for that, we want to create an App Store Connect API key. Let's go back to where we created the in-app purchase key. So let's click on generate API key. Let's name this App Store Connect API key. There we go. And then for the access app manager, let's generate that. And there we go. Again, you want to download it and make sure you place it into a safe place, because you can't actually download it again. Let's go back to the RevenueCat setup. And now let's drag and drop that file. So here is our auth key. Let's drag and drop it over there. Key ID is there. Issuer ID. Again, it has been generated right over here. Let's copy it out and paste it in there. Now, finally, you want to add a vendor number. You can get it by clicking on payments and financial reports, and you will see it actually on the top left corner of your screen. Now, this is confidential, so I'm just going to copy and paste it in here and cut to the next part of the step. Okay, now that I have pasted that in, let's save the changes. Great. So what you want to do is scroll down and grab your a public API key. It's right over here. Let's copy that out. or just click over here so we can just copy it. And now what you want to do is go back to Xcode and set it up. So let's just go into our app delegate and then import RevenueCat. Let's set up purchases, log level, debug, so we can see what we are doing. You may remove that line or just change it if you want to. And then you just go purchases.configure with API key. And I'm just going to paste whatever I copied out for my API key. Believe it or not, it's that simple. Now Xcode is set up, well, your project is set up to receive information from a RevenueCat. Next up, before we present the paywall, we want to create one. Let's just go back to our integration. Now that we are back over here, what we want to do is create some products. So let's go under products. And because we have already set up our, you know, entitlement keys for that P8 file from App Store Connect, when we are going to click on Add New and select Apple, you may have this option to import the products. So let's just do that. Let's import the product. It's just going to check, and then I'm going to select all three of them, and then let's import them. Okay, so now you can see there are no entitlements right over here. So what we want to do next is create an entitlement. So select entitlements and click on New. I'm just going to name it Pro. That's all right. And then Pro Access. There we go. Let's add that. So let's attach some products to this entitlement. Let's click on it. And then you will see that we may attach some products. Choose our product. Let's just go first with the weekly. Let's add that. Now let's attach all of the other two. Let's choose monthly. Add. There we go. And then finally the yearly one. Okay. Now that we have our entitlements, let's create an offering. So select offerings and let's create new, and then let's just name this default. That's fine. Now let's click on save. And now you see that the default has been created. Now it's time to add the packages, the products and the packages. So first of all, we are going to add some packages. So let's click on the new right over here. Let's start off with the weekly one. So weekly, and we are going to add weekly over there. Let's add that. Okay. And now what you want to add is basically want to attach a product to this package. So let's click over there and then attach, choose the product of weekly, attach. Okay. So we want to go back and then do the same things for the monthly and yearly. So plus, monthly, that's right, and then monthly, there we go, add, and then add a product to it, attach, choose a product of for the monthly, attach again, great, now let's do that finally for the yearly, and that's called annually right over here, okay, yearly, let's add that, and finally let's attach up the product to it. Attaching. Great. So you should see something like this. Now that we have our offerings, we want to create a paywall. So scroll a little bit down and select paywalls. And as you can see for the default offering head, we may create a paywall. So let's click on that one. And then we can select any of these. As you can see, there are quite a few right over here. And RevenueCat is adding some as we speak. So let's select this one. Now, this is a template. So we want to add all of the necessary information that we want to provide in this template when the paywall will be added. So let's see what we need. English US images. Let's just see. Paywall content is required for at least one language. Yeah, English US is just fine. Basically, for the image, I don't care about the background image. You can set all of this up. I'm going to go through only the necessary stuff, but feel free to add as many options or, you know, customize it to your liking. Let's talk about the main content. So here you can change the title, the subtitle, colors. Okay, this is the main content right over here. Okay. And then the packages. This is really important. Requires two items. So we have the weekly one. Let's add another package. Choose one. That would be the monthly one. And let's add also the yearly one. Okay. Now let's choose the default one. I say let's just go for the monthly one. And package name. Let's just go for, the product name. Package details. And I think total price and per month is just fine. Let's add that variable. Let's see, total price and per month. So yeah, you can just choose all of these variables. It's really, really nice. Package details for introductory offer if you have some, and all of the other ones. Now, let's just go for the call to action. The call to action is basically this continue button. Let's just have like buy now. Okay, call to action for an introductory offer if you have one, and all of the other options. Footer links, those are optional. You may have terms of service URLs or privacy policy URL, and show or not show the restore purchases button. It's not obligatory at this moment from Apple. It was sometime, but you may show it or hide it however you'd like to. And then finally, the close button. You may add a close button if you choose to. And that's it. Go ahead and customize your paywall to your liking. Now let's click on create that paywall. So there's an error in the localization, and I just found that under main content, you do need to add something. So I'm just going to go with title and subtitle over there. And let's just create that paywall. Okay, so yeah, create the paywall. It's fine. And you can just go back to the paywall editor and do your stuff. Now it's time to use this paywall. So let's go back to Xcode right over there. And then I'm going to do a preview, provide a content view. And then first of all, you want to import RevenueCat UI and RevenueCat. Now we are going to present the paywall when this view appears. And it's with this line, present paywall if needed and require the entitlement identifier pro. Remember the entitlement? We named it pro. This is how you are going to access it. So let's build and run and see how this looks like. Here we go. And it has been added. It's just sliding up, and then you may purchase right over here. And it's just going to simply work as it should. You may slide it down if you choose to. Whenever this view is going to be presented again, it's just going to pop up. But there's an even nicer way of doing this. So paywall footer, I'm just going to go for now as an example with a paywall footer without an offering, just paywall footer, just a simple paywall footer. I'm going to show you the condensed one in just a second. So this is just a paywall footer. It's just going to add it right over there. And of course, you may slide it up or down. Now, whatever, if you wanted a condensed version, let's just use that. Condensed equals true. Let's just build and run. And there we go. You may take a look at the old plans if you want to, or you just toggle them. It's really, really nice. Now, that is paywalls in RevenueCat. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Go ahead and check out the link in the description so you may sign up.